Ujamaa is a Swahili term that means familyhood or extended family, and it's often translated as cooperative economics. It was the cornerstone of Julius Nyerere's vision for the development of Tanzania, which he laid out in his 1967 Arusha Declaration. In this vision, Ujamaa was seen as a way to build a more equal and self-reliant society by encouraging the creation of cooperatives and collectives, particularly in the fields of agriculture and particularly in the fields of industry. He believed that Ujamaa would allow the people of Tanzania to break free from the cycle of poverty and dependency that had long been a feature of their society and to build a more equitable and a more just nation. Some of these things that we needed to bring into play, he argued that traditional extended family, the structure of many African societies in which people work together and shared resources, can be adapted and applied to the broader society as a way to promote economic development and social cohesion. Now, Ujamaa has been a significant influence on the development of Tanzania, and it remains an important part of the country's national identity. Now, I want to have a broader discussion of how we can apply those principles and bring it as it relates to African Americans here in this country. Ujamaa is one of the seven principles of Kwanzaa. It's a cultural holiday celebrated by many African Americans. The word Ujamaa comes from the Swahili language, and it means cooperative economics. It refers to the ideas of working together and supporting one another's businesses and communities rather than relying on outside sources for economic support. In the context of Kwanzaa, Ujamaa is seen as a way to build and strengthen the African American community by supporting and promoting economic self-sufficiency. It's often celebrated on the fourth day of Kwanzaa, along with the other six principles, such as unity, self-determination, collective work and responsibility, cooperative economics, purpose, and creativity. I want us to embody these principles throughout the year, not just at the tail end of the year. So here are some ways that you can practice Ujamaa during Kwanzaa. You can support locally owned businesses in your own community. You can help to build a sense of economic unity and foster economic growth in your community. You can participate in community events. This can help build a sense of cooperation and provide revenue for your community. You can share resources and skills with others in your community. This often can build a sense of mutual support and interdependence. You can work together with others to address issues facing your community, such as poverty, inequality. This can also help build a sense of collective ownership and responsibility for the well-being of your community. Hopefully, we embody these principles 365 days out of the year and not just 7 days out of the year. Then our communities can thrive. The youth that we leave behind us, the elders that paved the way before us. My name is Hannibal. I'm the executive director of FinLit Forum and FICO Finesse. I hope to assist you guys. I hope to have greater discussions with you guys. I love you guys. Later.